Dear students, welcome to this new video tutorial of our programming series, Object-Oriented Programming. As you know, we are carrying our things forward with C++ programming. Many concepts has already been covered in C++ programming. If you have not watched that videos, you can see the playlist section of our channel and also click the bell icon for regular updates. Subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. Now, in this particular tutorial, if we talk about today's session, this session is typecasting. You have already studied that particular concept in C programming. The same concept is applied over here as well. But the thing is, the syntax is changed. Apart from that, everything is same as per C programming. So, what is typecasting? So, typecasting is converting the type of one value or variable to another temporarily. We are not permanently changing the type. For that particular line in execution, we are changing the type from one to another for any data, and as you know, data is stored in the variable. So typecasting is applied to variable. For an example, integer to float or float to integer, integer to character or vice versa, character to integer. So what is the need of typecasting? In some of the scenario, for a particular line or scope, we need to convert the data type of a variable from one to another temporarily, not permanently. That can be done by two things. Either take a copy in another variable with that needed data type, so that will result in wastage of variables. And second option, which is more efficient option, is to convert the type temporarily. So that can be done using typecasting. And depending upon your compiler as well as data types you have taken, typecasting is categorized into two things: implicit typecasting and explicit typecasting. Implicit typecasting is also known as automatic typecasting, where you do not need to do anything by code to convert data type from one to another. Where in explicit typecasting or manual typecasting, we are writing the code to convert a data type from one to another. So we will see both the things within the demo program. We will take some values in variable, we will convert it explicitly as well as implicitly and see what happens. So now let's switch back to our IDE. So we are into our IDE and we are seeing the program for typecasting. We will see implicit typecasting as well as explicit typecasting. For this, quickly I am including header files, which is iostream.h as well as hash include conio.h for console manipulation. Again, it is a simple concept, so we are not creating class. We will be continuing this concept within void main. CLRSCR, which is used to clear the screen. Catch.ch to hold the output or get the, or read the character. Then after, I am taking two variables, integer a comma b. What I am doing over here is, we will read the value of a and b, or let us say give the static value as of now. Then after, we will print the division and see if the typecasting automatically as well as explicit occurs or not. So a equals to, let us say, 5 and b is equals to 2. What I'm doing is cout division is equals to, which is a static message, followed by a divided by b, right? So we are having the basic program where I'm dividing or I'm dividing the value a with b. So 5 divided by 2 will give me the output of 2.5, right? Now let us say what will be the output. So we are having the output division equals to 2. Why? It must be 2.5, right? So over here what happens is the implicit type casting, right? Where integer a is divided with integer b, the answer is 2.5, but both a and b are in the integer, so the resultant answer will be integer as well. So the 2.5 is converted into integer with value 2. So that was the concept of implicit typecasting. Now what if we want to have the output 2.5? Explicit typecasting must be applied. With float of a, we have to convert both the value into float temporarily. As I have already discussed, typecasting only converts type from one to another temporarily for that particular line or scope. So for this particular line, a and b both will be converted into float. So that will be converted into 5.0, this will be converted into 2.0, and the resultant answer will be 2.5. Now let's see if the expected output is there or not. So yes, as you can see, the division is 2.5. One more variation we can do over here is,
we can only convert one value and we can write B. It will also give me the same output. Because one of the type is float, right? So that way you can do the type casting. Another variation of converting the type into another type is, we have seen this data type in the bracket variable. You can do that as well, in the bracket data type followed by the variable, right? It will not throw any error and it will works fine. So what I'm doing is float in the bracket followed by A. Now let's see. So yes, we are having the same output. So this is it for type casting. I hope you have understood this concept. For your reference, I'm freezing the screen for some time and then after we will switch back to our presentation.
I hope you have understood this concept. Let's have a quick recap of whatever we have seen within this particular tutorial. We have seen the concept of type casting, the categories of type casting, that is implicit and explicit, what is the need of the type casting, as well as we have seen one demo program, right? Some questions that can be asked from this particular tutorial, they are listed over here. What is type casting? What is implicit type casting? What is explicit type casting? As well as, I'm giving you a program which has been listed over here. The program says, read two data, perform the division by converting the value from one to another. So for an example, user will enter two integer value and we will convert it to float or whatever is necessary. So perform this program by your own. Try to have the answer of this question that has been listed. Write us in the comment section in case of any queries or confusion. Like this video, share this video, subscribe to YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.